Hello to all my queers and dears who may or may not be here, and welcome back to the stream where we play nonviolent games, games that reward the player for intellectual and or emotional engagement, rather than participating in combat or other forms of violent gameplay. I know this is a lot later than usual, but I was out seeing Barbie, so I don't know how long this is necessarily going to be, but I might get tired because it is much later for me. Just give it a second to adjust. Close the program that's heavy on the memory. Okay. Let's start over, shall we? Hello to all my queers and dears who may or may not be here. Welcome back to the stream where we play nonviolent games, games that reward the player for intellectual and or emotional. Rather than participating in combat or other forms of violent gameplay. Tonight is obviously much later than usual, because I was at seeing Barbie. I don't know if I'll go as long as usual, because it is late, and I may get tired. I decided I wanted to try. Do at least a little bit. So without further ado, let's get started. I was murdered by all of you. Detective Jowd, who forced me into a corner. Lynn, the girl who was playing in the park. And finally, you, Inspector Gavinella. If you hadn't done what you did, I never would have pointed a gun at that kid. Yes. 10 years ago, on that day, a special investigation unit was working on a certain big case. We hauled in a young man, an important witness to our investigation. And then I did it. I made 2 very stupid mistakes. Detective, I'm telling you, I don't know anything about it. Fine, you're under no obligation to talk, of course. But if you don't, the special investigation unit can make the rest of your life a living hell. But I just been assigned to the special investigation unit, you see. They didn't share much info on big cases with a newbie like me yet, and I wanted to impress them. It was only supposed to be a simple matter of taking a statement, but I was too green. I pushed him too hard. I drove him into a corner and made him lose all hope. That was my first mistake. And then I made another mistake on top of that. Caminilla, got a minute? The chief wants to see you about your report. Got it. I'll be right there. You stay right here and be a good boy now. And that's when I did it. I left it behind in the interrogation room. My gun. How could you? He used my gun to escape. What he said is true. If I hadn't made that mistake, he never would have had a gun to point to Ben in the first place. We first found out about the Manipulator's existence during a certain overseas communication. For national security purposes, this country keeps tabs on the communications networks. Their particular communication is making a deal with a certain foreign country.
He said he wanted them to buy him, and his powers.
That's how we first heard about him. Of course, we didn't know what he looked like at the time. In order to prove those powers of his, he gave them two predictions. He foresaw two completely preposterous, impossible cases. The case of a man who would sing national secrets during a live rock concert broadcast, and the case of a man who would take the chief commissioner hostage in his own office. There's two inmates at the special prison, huh? We kept tabs on their communications and launched an investigation. And then finally, we pinpointed where they were going to meet tonight and staked it out. The restaurant, the chicken kitchen. The Manipulator planned on leaving this country tonight on a submarine that belongs to the other country in this deal. It's a submarine, but we haven't been able to find out where it could serve us. It's terrifying to think what would happen if his powers were formed. Right, highly unlikely that you're looking for peaceful purposes. Now they have that little girl as a hostage. We have to stop him before he leaves the country. This spotless record of yours, is it really that important to you? Of course, baby. In some ways, it's more important to me than my life. After all, it's because of my record that I'm able to get my hands on all the intel as head of the Special Investigation Unit. Because of my position, I get to direct all aspects of the investigation into the Manipulator case. The Manipulator case? That's why you cared about your record so much. Of course. Why else, maybe? I just never could believe it, man. Joe shooting Alma. I didn't care that he confessed. There was definitely something more to the story, some secret. I did everything I could to climb the ladder, everything in my power. And then I finally found the answer. It took 5 long years, though. The Manipulator, he's going to prove that Jade is innocent. There's one thing I just don't understand. If you were so determined to help Detective Jones, why didn't you help him escape from prison? That's an easy one, baby. Escaping from prison is a crime. I wasn't about to help him commit a crime after spending 5 years trying to prove him innocent. And he himself asked to be executed, you know. As a man of the law, I had to make sure the execution was stopped immediately. That's why I brought him before the Justice Minister, too. I needed to buy as much time as I possibly could. Well, that's it. There's one little unfortunate result of all this. Lynn completely misunderstood your intentions. Ha! That's a little misunderstand. My baby will come around and give me time. But there are more important things to do with our time tonight. All right.
Francisco, it's time to go. Out into the big wide world to rescue Miss Camilla.
Hold on, Missile. I have to talk to these two first.
Oh, okay, I understand. I just want one thing. I go where the wind takes me.
Little dumb kind of pressure on me. Mr. Superintendent, do you mind if I talk to you for a minute? I haven't always been a junkyard superintendent, you know. I used to be part of the police. The police, huh? Not as a detective, but as a medical examiner. I investigated victims' cause of death. 10 years ago, I was asked to autopsy a strange corpse. Hit by a meteorite fragment and died instantly. That's what the police report said. There were no signs of life. He was definitely dead. I looked up all about it. There were no signs of life. He was definitely dead. But I never filed an autopsy report. That's because the corpse suddenly vanished, leaving behind only one clue. And a new corpse. I bet that's what I've been chasing all night. Could you tell me more?
Yeah, sure.
I have an interest in recovering your memory and finding your true identity too. That's the only way I can describe it too. It was an unusual corpse. He was dead all right, no question about that, but there wasn't a scratch on him.
Not a scratch, but I thought you said he was hit by a meteorite fragment.
I don't understand it any more than you do. I was completely bewildered, but when I tried to autopsy him, I was even more puzzled. I couldn't perform the autopsy.
Couldn't? What do you mean?
The scalpel went in, but I couldn't cut. As soon as I tried to make an incision, it would heal up in the very next instant. And that's how it went, and no scarring or blood either. And I never had the chance to solve the mystery.
That's because the corpse had been vanished, Alex.
The morgue is well guarded. Nobody could have stolen that body. But there is one way the corpse could have disappeared.
What's that?
It got up, opened the door, and walked out on its own.
What?
He was dead, but he wasn't dead. We saw with our own eyes tonight. Not even that explosion killed him. He didn't feel when he slammed his own fist on that stove.
The corpse left behind some data from some testing I did. I got some readings from some kind of radiation coming off that body.
Radiation? I used all kinds of instruments, but I couldn't determine exactly what kind of radiation it was. Some undiscovered type from a world unknown.
Well, it could be.
That's right. It was coming from that meteor, right, fragment.
I went to that park and tested the spot where the meteorite fell. Just as I expected, I detected radiation coming from that crater. It was the exact same pattern of radiation as that of the corpse. At the time, I thought he was some kind of immortal being. He would die, only to come back to life. I wanted to research it all in depth, so I quit my job as a police medical examiner. Several years later, I came to learn the connection between my research and the Manipulator case, thanks to the arrival of this crazy character here.
Oh, stop now, Professor. You won't say a word.
year ago, I'd say. This man in white came dancing into my research lab here. I heard there was an oddball here, research terms. Is that you, baby? What are you? Who are you to be calling any of these oddballs? I was investigating the Manipulator case, though. And then I heard there was a man with the police force to study the meteorite. When I heard that, it was like a meteorite had struck me on the head. At the time, we were just starting to get leads on the Manipulator. We didn't know who it was yet, but we knew he was communicating with a certain foreign country. In one of those communications, we heard the Manipulator say this: "The source of my power is not of this world." And that's when I put two and two together. The Manipulator case and Tamsin somehow connected. Which also explained how 5 years ago you used your powers to manipulate a birthday surprise a little girl made for her mother. He added that gun to the contraption, most likely by controlling the mirror. Basement here. You built that to try and help Detective Jowd? That's right. Jowd and I worked together back when I was on the force. I used the reports of his case to try and recreate the device, but there was just one part of it that I couldn't reproduce, no matter how hard I tried. I only told Jowd it did something it shouldn't have, made an impossible move. I added that part to the device I recreated. I put in a part that would allow it to rotate. Otherwise, the gun wouldn't fire. That must mean somebody manipulated the contraption. As a result, we proved to ourselves that the Manipulator actually existed.
Inspector Cavanilla!
Hey, baby. Sorry about that phone call. It must have sounded like a real villain. I hated to spoil your image of me. Of that cool cat inspector you always looked up to. Is that really the image you had of him?
Inspector Camilla, I'm sorry, I just heard you were chasing after that man all this time to try and help Detective Jowd.
This Manipulator is such a dangerous character. I was hoping you didn't have to be involved.
So that's why you had me arrested tonight, isn't it?
Like I always say, if somebody's in the way, throw them in the slammer. Yikes. Tonight, I really thought we finally had him. But my body gave out on me right at the critical moment. It's like a cruel joke. But a joke is a joke. You might as well laugh.
Jack! The minister called off the execution order. And while he was at it, he let Detective Jowd go free until tomorrow morning, too.
That's a pretty extreme while he was at it. Sorry, I took so long to get here. You can leave the rest to me. There you go. You've always been back there. You make everybody else run around and swoop in at the last second. Jowd. 5 years ago, you left this court with me, just before you turned yourself in. I promise to give it back to you one day.
I've been waiting so long, Detective Jack. Waiting for this day to come!
Thanks for not giving up on me, Lynn. Okay, I'm off. Good luck, my old friend. This present is just what I need. Thank you. Glad you like it.
Thistle, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
You and I have to go find that man. I need your help. Will you do this with me?
Sure, but how? But sure, but how? We don't know where the submarine is and the phone lines.
They use communication cables to make that work. We'll get you hooked up somehow. We'll see. Could you wait here until we do, please?
Okay.
Kelly. This true self you're looking for. I bet you'll find it soon. Alright, I'm leaving, Inspector Cavanaugh.
It's almost done. Not who I thought it was. I'm actually further from knowing who I am. And now I don't feel so alone. Each one of us, for his or her own, is looking for the truth. Together, I think we can shed light on these mysteries and drive away the darkness. But it's almost done.
Maybe I'll just do that much tonight, just like a half an hour. Even a little less, honestly. No, a lot less, actually. Okay, I should do a little more.
Lynn kept her promise about getting me hooked up. About 2 hours before dawn, the phone rang.
Jowd. Sissel, are you listening? We need your powers. No time to talk. We'll be waiting for you. Well, you'd better get going. This long night is drawing.
A single telephone line connects me and the other Sissel, but that single line spreads out like a spider's web to ensnare the fates of many people. And I just reached the center of the web.
Welcome to the Unoa. Welcome to the Unoa, Detective Jowd. Welcome to the Genoa, Detective Jowd. Welcome to the Detective... to the Genoa, Detective Jowd.
My detective sense must have gotten rusty. I didn't even sense your presence here in the dark.
That's because I switched the power to my mask off, Detective Jowd.
I used your phone. Hope you don't mind.
You'd track us here, especially seeing as you're a death row inmate.
And I'm equally surprised about your choice of transportation. The submarine, eh?
But how did you find us, my man? Not even the police knew whether you know it was going to service, confound it.
We detectives have a little say. If there's something you want to know about a case, ask the criminal.
The bullet the man in red was shot with had a radio transmitter.
I have a little song.
Cabanella has given me some pretty weird presents in the past, but they always prove useful. This one was a radio receiver made to look like a pocket watch. Where is that man, Ray? I know he's on this submarine somewhere.
Oh, Sissel, you mean?
You.
You can relax. That's nothing but his shell.
His shell, eh?
His spirit isn't here right now. Most likely right about now, he's controlling your daughter.
Please, I beg you, let my daughter go. If you need a hostage, take me, please. Just let her go.
Bah. There's something our nation needs. Sissel has it. That's all we care about, my man. Nothing else matters. However, it would appear Sissel has underestimated us. He's left behind his precious bargaining chip here.
Bargaining chip?
Our nation has already researched it. This product that Sissel has to offer. The source of his powers.
What in the world was that?
The Temsic fragment. It gives spirits special powers. And now our deal with Sissel is concluded as far as we're concerned.
What are you talking about?
What a mistake to make, right at the most critical moment. Now then, Detective Joud. Farewell.
Trusty nose of yours is different now?
I'm sorry to say I don't think it can.
Why did I even bother to ask? We do have the power to swap objects. Let's go find that lady detective and the little lady together.
You got it!
Oh. The telephone is ringing.
Wow! It's Miss Camilla! I just know it! My trusty nose is practically screaming it at me!
I think you'd call that more of a hunch. Anyway, let's get to that phone before it stops ringing.
You bet! Hello? Hello? Miss Camilla? Hello? It's no use! This black hello just doesn't like me!
Just create a path for me, Miss Old. I'll come right over. Go to that phone before the line goes dead.
You bet!
Hello?
Sissel, look! The black hello it came off the hook!
I better answer it fast.
Hello? Is anybody there?
It's her, the little lady. It's Sissel, where are you?
Somebody please answer.
She can't hear my voice.
You too, huh? Oh good, I thought she was ignoring me. Somebody help me. Lynn, please.
Miss Lynn.
Miss Lynn!
We better hurry.
Let's go, Sissel.
Go there. She drowned.
It's no use, nobody's answering. Miss Camilla! Miss Lynn! Oh, poor Miss Lynn!
Yeah, she can't seem to catch a break. Looks like another tragedy. Sorry to keep you waiting, little lady.
Sissy, I knew you'd come! Miss Camilla! Miss Camilla! And Missile, too. I'm so glad to see her, alright. Well, I wouldn't say I'm alright, exactly. Hey, wait a minute. Missile, your voice. I think I remember hearing it somewhere before. What? My voice?
That's right. Camilla has a core now, so that means she did hear Missile's voice before, when he saved her that time.
So that was you, wasn't it, Missile? You're the one who saved me in the park tonight. Thank you. Miss Camilla! I'm so glad I was born your little pup.
Missile, could you stay here and watch over your mistress for a while?
Huh? But don't you need my powers?
See what I can do on my own in a while. After all, you're the only one to protect her.
Okay, I'll do it! Thank you, Missile.
Talk to the little lady a little more, and then I'd better do something about the detective lady. Can I talk to you a minute?
Yes, Sissy?
Could you tell me what happened to you? What happened after I last saw you at your old house?
Oh, let's see. After that, I think I fell asleep. I woke up to the sound of an engine.
She was already in the submarine.
I thought to myself, I have to escape. Next thing I knew, I found myself in this big room. I was so tired, I couldn't move, and then... Camilla! I was so relieved. I don't remember what happened after that.
She must have passed out, the poor thing. You've been through so much. You were very brave.
I think Lynn's probably been through more than me.
You've both been brave.
Oh, Sissel, you're here.
Lynn, what in the world happened here?
I don't know. Huh? I just sort of blacked out all of a sudden. Next thing I know, I was dead.
Yeah, I guess you wouldn't know.
And where's Detective Jack? Is he all right?
I don't know.
Huh?
The room he was just in just disappeared all of a sudden. Now it's all making even less sense than before.
After we left the super's office, we followed after the man in red. We tracked him with that radio transmitter Inspector Canella fired into him with a bullet.
The man in red took a boat out to sea from a small harbor on the edge of town. Detective Jowder and I managed to secretly stow away on his boat, and then we sneaked onto the submarine with him when it surfaced. Before long, the submarine dove back down again. Detective Jowder and I decided to split up. He would take care of the telephone line, and I would look for Camilla.
I found Camilla hiding here in the engine room. She had escaped and run away here.
Wow, that's quite an adventure. What happened next?
I don't know.
Oh.
There was a flash of light and all of a sudden, next thing I know I was dead.
Well, sounds like I'd be quicker to see for myself.
Sissel, are you okay? Camilla? Hello. Or is it Detective now? It's been 10 years since we last met. Are you really that man from the park 10 years ago? Well, I see there's no need to introduce myself. Give Camilla back. She has nothing to do with any of this. Afraid I can't do that. This is my last chance. The phone is ringing. It's not for me. Nobody ever calls the dead. The fact that you're here means that my revenge plan has failed. Revenge plan? It didn't happen tonight, did it? His execution. Well, knowing him, I half expected as much. That's why I was waiting here like this, waiting for him to show up. Wouldn't it be just what he wanted, to be executed by his own daughter? I heard about 10 years. Sorry about what happened. Revenge? Nobody could possibly know what I... What in the world? An explosion? Uh-oh. I've got a bad feeling about this. Have I been had? Look out! Look out!
Revenge, huh? It's a feeling I just can't understand.
Of course not. You're not him.
She's right. I'm not him, am I?
He was going to shoot Detective Joud. As Camilla, when he came to rescue her, it's just too horrible.
Anyway, let's bring you back to life. Again.
You didn't have to add the again part.
Let's see, what was it that this time?
Was that mysterious explosion? You know how detectives love a good mystery. It's like a shot of vitamins. What do you mean for a dead one?
Anyway, I guess we should look for a way to stop that explosion.
Alright, let's do this thing. Finding clues is like a dose of minerals to a detective. Talking about, the receiver has to be off the hook first, silly. Well, don't look at me, I can't do it. I don't have any hands or feet right now. Somebody please answer the phone. If you want something done, you have to do it yourself. Somehow managed to knock down the receiver.
Somehow managed to say it's not on the
phone. Come on, hurry, now's your chance to get on the phone. It might be Detective Jared.
Hello, anybody there? If anybody's still there, get yourself here on the double. We're about to head out. Speak up, why don't you answer? Anyway, come if you're coming, we're leaving. So it must be true what they say, that there are restless ghosts on board. That does it. I promise to turn over a new leaf bomb.
Who is he calling restless ghosts?
Well, it's true, neither one of us is really resting in peace.
Anyway, looks like the sub just lost one of its crew.
I guess that means the fate of the sub has changed slightly.
Sizzle has underestimated us and left behind his precious bargaining chicken.
Decided to conclude the deal without the other players. They're just going to go ahead and steal the 10-sec crack. But that's cheating!
The objective has been achieved. We now detach the control room as planned.
Yes, sir. Farewell, sir.
Sizzle, what just happened? The whole room just disappeared with Detective Chow in it.
Don't worry, man. I bet Detective Chow can take care of himself. The main thing right now is rescuing you and the little lady.
I can't believe this is happening.
Now then, I'd better hurry along before Sizzle discovers what he's lost and comes after me. You know I will be his coffin. Then I'm buried here in the deep sea forever. Farewell, Sizzle.
So that's the cause of the giant explosion. Huh? What is? Don't tell me there's another thing you've forgotten. The torpedo, it's like... Well, you've heard of a missile before, haven't you?
Yeah, sure. But a different missile comes more readily to mind.
It looks like he plans to sink the submarine with that thing. This is not good. You have to do something before that torpedo is fired. Can't let it launch. What can it do? Let's just get to the torpedo as fast as we can. Maybe we can find a way to stop it somehow.
So,
a true detective never gives up.
I'm assuming you just ignore
it. There's no time, it's gonna launch. It's no use, there's nothing we can do for you.
Thank you.
tried to take it on from us.
Explosion.
I've got a bad feeling about this. Have I been had? Look out!
At least now we know the cause of the explosion for sure.
I can't believe he'd sink his own submarine. What a waste.
Okay, but more importantly, we need to get to that torpedo. I better find a path to it somehow. Guess I better rewind the clock again and see if I can pick up any other clues.
Sick fragment, you're mine at last. The objective has been achieved. Now detach the control room as planned.
Yes, sir. Farewell, sir.
Now then, I'd better hurry along before Cecil discovers what he's lost and comes after me. And no one will be his coffin. It lies buried here in the deep sea forever. Farewell, Cecil.
So that's the cause of the, what is,
So time, it's gonna launch. Don't worry, we can still find a way to stop it. But how? Even if the torpedo does launch, we just have to stop it from detonating, right? There's still something we can do, I hope. There's still something I can do. I hope. I was hoping that the strongest part of that sentence. Okay, here goes.
I'm sure this poor little rat will thank us too. Oh, well, did it get it? Do you know how
a torpedo works.
No, I can't say I do.
I saw it explained once in a book.
On impact, the fuse in the tank is depressed.
That, in turn, sets off the detonator. How do we stop it? They didn't explain anything about that.
Now the detectives sure know a lot. Or not.
I think those outside parts are supposed to be weights of some sort. Spinning black things, right? Apparently, their spinning held the torpedo maintainment to balance. They must be pretty good. They don't press it, the tornado is going off. But you know, there should be a safety device in there somewhere. Safety device sounds common. You have to put the safety on before the scene blows up.
Out of the way, we can't get the safety device.
Right. Only our missile is here right now.
We have to get this little creature loose.
Submarine. We have to set that safety and keep the torpedo from detonating.
No, but I can't have a map.
This is bad. We couldn't stop the torpedo from launching. Don't worry, if we could stop it from going off, there's still hope, right? Our missile doesn't have one, but usually these kind of missiles have a safety device. Sounds like that safety device is our only clue. Guess I'd better rewind the clock again and see if I can pick up any other clues. Oh. At least we start. Thank you. So we gotta stop the weights at the right time to make the rat. Get out of there, I guess. I thought maybe we could get it on a slant, but... Ah, there we go. Great, we've dumped the little creature off. Wow, those weights were heavy enough to turn the whole torpedo over. Now for that safety device. Right. There, we clamped the safety device on. We did it! That should keep this torpedo from exploding. There's just one problem. Oh, what's that? The torpedo is still going to impact. We can't do anything about that. Uh-oh. Sorry, I just, trying to get a good angle. What was that noise? Looks like the torpedo still hit the submarine. But it looks like the submarine is still okay. This changes everybody's fate, including little rats. Sizzle, we did it! What's the matter? You still look unhappy. That torpedo from blowing up slow over the gaping hole in the submarine. You're right, I guess. I guess that's just what missiles do. They're unstoppable! Anyway, I guess we better get back to the present as quickly as we can. Right, I'm worried about the moon. Managed to stop death for now, but it hasn't disappeared altogether. It's now slowly but surely filling the room. Water is seeping through the hole where the torpedo hit. I've got to get them out of here. I'd better go meet up with Lynn. Went out, but this machine apparently still works. Fortunately, I guess it won't run for very long. Maybe I can use its movements to help me create a path. I better hurry over, it's not safe to stay here. I just don't have the power to stop that water from coming in. Camilla, you're awake! How do you feel? I'm so sorry. I'm sorry I pointed that gun at you. Don't worry about that. That wasn't you. Miss Camilla! Oh, Missile, you're here! Oh, poor Miss Camilla. Miss Lynn, what should we do? We have to get out of here before any more water comes in. Sissel should be along any second. I knew Sissy would come. And Missy is here, too. I'm so happy everybody's going to be with me now. Camilla! It's Camilla! She's just exhausted. I'll get you out of here. If it's the last thing I do. Oh, I think I'm gonna cry.
A whimper, as the case may be. I better send Lynn a signal. I better send a signal to Lynn that I'm here before it's too late.
Oh, look at that flashlight. It's Sissel! He's here! Up you go.
Glad you're here, Sissel. Sorry for the wait. Looks like this room is going to fill up with water fast. We better get out that door as quick as we can. We won't be getting out that door, I'm afraid. The water pressure is too great already. I can't open it. What? What does water pressure mean? Think of it as the force of the water holding the door closed. The water level keeps getting higher and higher in here. So the only way out of here is up, huh? Exactly. Okay, got it. Let's look for a path that goes up. Hey, look at that ladder. I wonder if we can get it down somehow. Good idea. Let's try it. Oh, and by the way...
Yes?
I can't swim. Neither can Camilla. Don't you have any good news for me? Let me think about it. In the meantime, could you hurry, please? Did it, Sissel. Thanks! Eek!
Be careful.
What was that?
Looks like water seeping isn't the only thing we have to worry about.
Sissel, the flashlight doesn't work anymore.
Hey, don't get mad at me.
Maybe the contacts are bad or something. Hey, I know you can fix it with your powers.
Okay, now it's just taking things too far.
Hey, great. Did you used to be an electrician in your past life or something?
That's a cruel question, considering the circumstances. Now all we have to do...
Let's get to that door and we're safe. Eek!
Oh boy.
What happened now?
Looks like the submarine decided to rear up on its hind legs.
I can't believe we're still okay after that fall. Either we're really lucky or we're dead and we just haven't realized it yet.
Come on now, as if the latter could be true.
What now? The water sure is rising fast. Come on. Just have to go up, to the top. See how I can help with my next tricks.
So, other than the helping Jout escape, I believe I remember that this is the hardest part of the game.
Oh, well, I think I see a familiar flame. Sissel, there you are. How's it going?
How's it going? I'd say it's going pretty badly. You do understand how dangerous this is.
Of course, after all, just ask anybody who knows me how much I hate to come back.
Maybe he's been in danger of drowning before, so... Okay, would you create a path for these ladies?
Of course!
haunting me. Maybe it's a challenge?
It might be just that.
If I wasn't holding Camille, I could probably do this. Thistle, you're not telling Miss Lynn to leave Parkham behind, are you?
You just be quiet for a minute, Thistle.
Water is still rising. It's up to my knees. And it's freezing cold. Hang in there, Miss Lynn. Thanks, Miss Lynn. I doubt they're doing that,
isn't it? Wait, how large the thing is.
Hey, Sissel, my arms are full, but my legs are free. If you could just move this piston to go a little easier to climb, I think I'd do it.
So in order to do that, we need three different sizes of fans.
Great, you made a staircase for me.
Better hurry, I don't think that water is going to wait for you.
Steam is getting in the way. It's too hot to get through. There's no way to go around either. Think you can do something? Of course we can. If I swap the pipes,
it changes how the steam comes out.
Oh, I get it, because the cracks in each pipe are different, right?
Each pipe sprays steam out in a different way. But that'll be.
I'm out of water again. Oh, I wish I could drink it all up for you. No, Missile, it's too salty.
I think the Morella plant is dead, so we can't.
Whatever, just do something about the steam. Give it to me, Missile. Thanks, Missile.
Thank you.
close then. Not that I can see all that while there's steam in here. I guess we'll switch the pipes around so you can get across. That's right, don't give up, Miss Holly. Your neck's really starting to hurt. Okay, but there's not any pipe that doesn't have, like...
Take a little warm mist.
Hey, that was no warm mist, it was boiling hot steam.
Anyway, it looks like you're the key player for this one, Missile.
I don't think my powers alone are gonna be enough.
Yeah, clearly.
That look? It looks great. All that horrible steam is clear out of the way.
Okay, it's not far now. We'll try to keep it away.
Ouch.
There we go.
There. If I could just make it to that door, we can escape. Yell at me?
Missile.
I'm gonna yell at you when you're so sweet about it. Let's look for something to pull Miss Lynn up with.
Something to whisk Miss Lynn up and glide her ever so gently to the top.
Hey, are you being sarcastic? This is what I'm talking about. Okay, raise a leg.
Darkness and sea water. The submarine continues to sink down.
thank you so much to all my queers who were and weren't here tonight. Especially because it was a bit later than usual. I got a friend.